Hello. So today we are going to be rating all of the bookstores that I visited in New York. I do have a vlog covering the trip on my other channel, mostly discussing the multilingual or international bookstores that I visited, but there are, in my opinion, a lot of good clips in that one, so you can check that out as well. But we'll just be going through all of the bookstores that I visited and doing my entirely subjective ratings. So first up, we're going to do Posman Books, and this is the location that is inside Chelsea Market. In addition to my ratings for this bookstore, I have the best tip ever for visiting this. I have been to Chelsea Market every time that I've been to New York, and I really, really like it. It's very cool. If you don't know, there's a lot of restaurants, a lot of different like little shops, there's all kinds of different food that you can try. Beautiful location, and it's right by Highline Park, so lots of cool stuff around it, but it is usually packed. Like, it is so busy all the time. I've never really been able to explore this bookstore anytime that I've been here before because there's always been so many people. But this time I happened to go early. So most of the things in Chelsea Market don't open until 10 or 11, but Posman Books actually opens at 9. And so you can go in, and I mean, it was empty. Like, I will show you the clips. Like, there were like probably 20 people in the entire building. You can browse the bookstore. There were probably like 5 of us in the bookstore. Take your merry time, and then you can walk around Chelsea Market and figure out what you want to check out once it opens. So I would say Posman Books, I'm gonna give them like an 8 out of 10 on selection. Very standard, like not as bog standard as like a Barnes & Noble, but they're also not like reinventing the wheel here. And they've got magnets, they've got pins, they've got all kinds of cute like tchotchke things. All right, next up, we're gonna talk about Unoppressive Non-Imperialist Bargain Books. First of all, name, 50 out of 10. So this is located in the approximate neighborhood of the West Village. And this is like Instagram gold right here. They have their name on the front of their store, and it's this like shabby little hole in the wall. Apparently there's the store cat. I did not see the store cat, but I saw it on Google. This is a very, very small store. There's like one wall of shelves which had like comics, a little tiny shelf in the middle, I think, and then another wall. And unfortunately, I didn't see anything that I wanted to buy here. They do have used books and then maybe some new books. I'm not sure. Their prices were very, very reasonable. And there were books that, honestly, if the store was located at home, I might have bought. But I had to carry anything that I bought with me all around New York and then also home. They did have a few things that were like kind of anti-capitalist readings and stuff. So I would imagine that the selection at this store rotates a lot. And so I definitely think that it's worth a shot and worth a visit and worth an Instagram photo, you know? Next up, Three Lives and Company. This is also in West Village, very close to the other store. It is a corner store, very, very pretty, could be in a movie kind of bookstore, very literary, fiction-esque. And there were a lot of employees working when I was there. And so I think if you wanted a recommendation, you probably could have gotten some really good, you know, discussion about the type of books that they have and everything. I didn't spend a ton of time in here. There were quite a few people in there, but I was still able to like get around, see the books that I wanted to see. You know, it wasn't bad at all. Oh, next up, we have You and Me Books. This is a tiny, again, most of these are tiny, it's New York City, independently owned bookstore in Chinatown that is, I think according to her website, the first and only female Asian owned bookstore in New York. And this was just precious. The book selection was very good. You could tell that she was really, really valuing all kinds of different diversity in her book selections. There were also used books, but the new books, you know, were obviously a little bit more curated, as tends to be the case. But also, beyond the book selection, it was just the, you know, sense of community and stuff. And I said this in my other video, there were people coming in the whole time that I was there telling her, like, I'm so glad that this is here, like, it means so much to me. She was talking to people about, you know, just coming in to sit down and work. There's a little space in the back that has, like, chairs and everything, and it was just such a nice experience. I did end up picking up a book here, and I will absolutely be back 100%. And neighborhood is also a 10 out of 10. Chinatown was so beautiful, and I really, really wish that I had been able to spend more time there. I kind of went towards the end of my trip, and I didn't really have time to explore, you know, try out restaurants or anything like that, but it's an absolutely beautiful neighborhood, and I really want to check it out more. Next up, we have Books of Wonder, which is a children's bookstore in kind of Flatiron District area, and this was a really, really cool store. This is actually a pretty big store for New York. And they had a ton of children's books and then also a lot of like YA and middle grade books. 11 out of 10 because they had a bathroom. Amazing. So many cool children's books that I'd never seen, never heard of. If my niece didn't already have hundreds of books, I could have gone absolutely crazy buying books there. Just a cool place to look through if you have kids, if you have any kids in your life, if you just enjoy children's literature or illustrations or middle grade or YA, I think that is definitely worth a stop. The staff was really nice. Okay, next up we have Rizzoli Bookstore, and this is kind of Midtown, Flatiron area, and this is a very, very schnazzy looking bookstore. Apparently it used to be at a different location and that closed and it moved here, so it's not quite as like picturesque as it once was, but it is still a really, really pretty store. You can tell it's a little bit more bougie. Like, this one had books in Spanish, French, Italian, and so, you know, kind of had a little bit of a posh European vibe. They had a security guard, which was like a, you know, a little bit of a vibe ruiner, even though I felt like I could have taken him. He was staring at his phone the whole time, but anyway, they were also having an event with like three authors. I was there in the afternoon and they were having the event in the evening. So I think that they do have quite a bit of stuff going on. You and Me Books also had author signings and stuff I saw on their Instagram. So I did not love the experience of browsing at Rizzoli because it did feel kind of like they were like looking at you, or at least looking at me like, what are you doing here? But that also could have been because I had a camera. So I don't know. But I do think it's worth a visit. And then next up, we have some of my international bookstores. Koryo Books is also kind of Midtown area, Koreatown. And this is a Korean bookstore and K-pop extravaganza. I think, as far as I could tell, I think that all of this is in Korean. Like, all of the books are in Korean. So it's very cool to visit, very cool to see, but if you can't read Korean, then you're probably not going to be shopping for books there, but I still think it's worth looking at. And then if you do like K-pop, you know, of course, check it out. And similarly, but differently, Kinokuniya is also in Midtown, and this is a Japanese bookstore, but they do have a whole floor dedicated to English books as well. So the top floor is manga, anime stuff. Second, like, main floor is English and assorted other things, and then the bottom floor is stationery and Japanese books. So this is a really big store, very, very cool. If you have anybody in your life that likes stationery, if you have anybody that likes, you know, plushes, that kind of thing, this was a really cool place to check out. Definitely recommend it. And it's also right next to Bryant Park, which is beautiful, and it seemed like there was a lot of events going on in Bryant Park as well, so check out that whole situation. Albertine is in the Upper East Side. It's right outside of Central Park, and it is a French language bookstore. They do have some English books as well. I think French literature translated into English. They had a table of those books, but the rest of the store is in French, and it was so beautiful. The upstairs has a ceiling, a painted ceiling. I can't remember what it's called, but anyway, that was really beautiful. And the whole place is beautiful. They also have a security guard. You have to go through a metal detector to get into the building, which is weird, but really, really pretty building. This person is just driving around looking at me. Definitely recommend a visit, even if you're not speaking or learning French. I think it's just really pretty. And you're probably going to Central Park anyway, so you might as well. And then finally, for this visit, I did go to Mil Mundos in Bushwick, which is in Brooklyn. And this was a Spanish and English language bookstore. It has the books all mixed together, so there's not a Spanish section and an English section. They are all together, which I just loved. This had used books and new books as well. A really, really cool selection of books. Again, I felt like something that you could tell was really well curated. They had amazing political writing like Franz Fanon and a bunch of books that I've looked at and really, really wanted to read before. Again, if I could have brought like a whole other suitcase to fill up with books and had a, you know, bigger budget, then I could have gone crazy. But I did just get a collection of Samantha Schweblin stories here. You know, I talked to the person at the counter and she was really, really nice. It was a very, very nice vibe. Like, it just feels like you're in someone's like home somewhere, but not in a weird way. I really enjoyed the experience of going there and I will definitely go back. There were also three other bookstores that I wanted to go to but wasn't able to make time to go to, mostly because a lot of them are a little bit farther away from like central areas, but I'm gonna put them on the screen and I definitely want to check them out when I go back. And if any of you live in New York or are visiting, you can also check them out and let me know how they are. If you're visiting New York, check some of these out. If you're not visiting New York, I hope you got to live vicariously. I definitely enjoyed revisiting all of these places in my mind. So thank you for watching and I will see you in the next video.